Welcome to Center Stage with Angelina and Remy. And today's episode, Remy is going to talk about the addition to her family. She has something that she would like to share, the little love of her life, the new love in her life. And so stay tuned to find out all about it.
I have been trying to get a dog for a long time. And I needed one for the first time in my life that had predictable behavior. I couldn't get a rescue because most often they don't know all the different animals that make them up.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And but a Heinz 57 makes a great dog. Mm-hmm. But I was needing a therapy dog to help with several things. But anyway, I searched around and I ended up getting a Glen of Imau Terrier. His name is Murphy.
Love the name.
Yes.
That's such a cute name.
Murphy is a... It fits into a T. Mm-hmm.
And it's a Scottish dog, right?
Irish.
Irish.
Irish. My husband would say he's Irish Catholic. but he is rare. The first one was brought to the United States in 1969. They are best known for being the most calm and the most quiet, most silent. Mm-hmm. Now, he can bark, but he's not like a regular terrier. He doesn't mm-hmm. bark all the time.
He's just kind of a quiet disposition uh-huh. about him altogether.
Yeah, and he really does bring more joy to the household than anyone could ever believe. Mm-hmm. So there's many things about that that are important for mental health. But first, let me tell you a little bit more about him. He is 4 months old, and he is he was 22 pounds a couple days ago. He'll get up to about 40. Mm-hmm. He's not going to be real small. Mm-hmm. The funny thing about him is that his front legs are a bit short compared uh-huh. to his back legs. Because as he grows, his chest area is what's going to get kind of big.
Uh-huh. You know?
And that kind of makes him look real sturdy. And uh-huh. even my husband remarked, which is miracle in itself, that he could not believe the strength in his back legs. And he mm-hmm. said, the muscles are there. I mean, they mm-hmm. are already there.
Wow.
He has grown so much since we first got him that now I'm having trouble picking them up.
Uh-huh.
Trying to pick them up as much as I can because it's going to be over.
Right. There's going to be a day you can't carry him. So.
And I hate that.
Take advantage of.
That's mm-hmm. right. But anyway, he needed to be a dog that could be what he is, a quieter terrier, and not a big dog. Mm-hmm. And this breed is, they are actually, I was quite disappointed. But the sire is in Finland, and the mother... the vet would say the bitch.
Yeah.
That's hard for me to do. Lives in California. He was delivered by the vet in Lake Alfred, Florida. So, you know, he's got quite a pedigree. Mm-hmm. But as I read a book that a friend of mine let me borrow, it said that he was the common man's dog. Which I found hilarious. I mean, I don't, you know, I usually get a rescue, really. It doesn't mean anything to me. But mm-hmm. it's just funny. And he is really exactly as I was told he would be. Mm-hmm. I mean, I am struck by how he is, just like they said.
Uh-huh.
And so he is a therapy dog in that he helps mostly with anxiety and depression. Mm-hmm. Now, there's therapy dogs that go into nursing homes, hospitals, and that kind of thing to mm-hmm. do therapy. They do make people better.
Mm-hmm.
And they have proven that they are good for your health.
Yes. Yeah, and there have been many studies done to prove that is the case, that they are very beneficial to someone's life.
I mean, it's so out there now that you really don't, I mean, people know. Mm-hmm. I mean, they just know. And so it's common knowledge. They don't always know exactly why they're so helpful.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure everybody has heard of the dogs that can predict a seizure.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's just a small thing.
Mm-hmm.
If the last tsunami that we had, I mean, years ago, maybe 5 or 6 years ago,
mm-hmm.
the real huge tsunami took out a million people. Mm-hmm. Well, the interesting part of that was that there were no animals there.
Mm-hmm.
The animals knew before it happened mm-hmm. that something bad was happening.
Right.
Or getting ready to. And they simply moved inward,
mm-hmm.
away from the coast.
Mm-hmm.
So that pretty much, to me, tells me all I need to know.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they are so valuable. They are absolutely, I believe, necessary for children
mm-hmm.
so they can learn compassion and mm-hmm. empathy, if, you know, or at least be taught what it is. Mm-hmm. And how to treat them.
Right.
So, for me, with attention deficit disorder, if things are going well, he can be a real big part of helping me focus.
Mm-hmm.
And we are working on those particular issues. I have not chosen yet who I'm going to have come, and hopefully to the house, and train him, because you have to have someone certified in training a dog as a therapy dog.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I haven't found a good one yet that I'm really...
Mm-hmm. You're still
searching.
In the search.
But, that being said, I will be getting one very soon. He is growing so fast. He's lost 3 teeth. He's teething, and that's the biggest problem we have right now. He wants to chew everything. But I will just tell a humorous side to him. He loves shoes.
Uh-oh.
And
most dogs do.
Well, he loves them, and what he does is one day, when I was in the bathroom, he trotted behind me and went into the closet.
Mm-hmm.
Came out with a shoe.
Mm-hmm.
And I told him, I said, okay, fine, that's fine. He took it out into the family room. Then he came back in and trotted into the closet and got another shoe. He took that out and deposited it somewhere in the living room later that I found.
Uh-huh.
And then he came back for a third shoe.
Uh-huh. And he was hoarding shoes.
Yes, absolutely. Mm-hmm. The hoarders are everywhere, people. So he took it out and then came for a fourth shoe. Mm-hmm. The interesting thing about him is that he doesn't tear them up. He just likes to run around with them in his mouth.
Yeah.
He did the same with a plastic watering can. He looks so absurd.
Mm-hmm.
Just running with his head held up, and he's got a watering can.
Uh-huh.
The other interesting thing about this breed is that they have very large front paws.
Mm-hmm.
And that is because, being the common man's dog, he would be, if he was on a farm, he would be digging for all types of vermin, but I think mostly badgers back when they used them. So they would use these huge front paws. They look hilarious on them right now. But, you know, to really dig, and find that badger or rodent. And then the owner could tell when the badger was caught, and they would pull the dog out by its tail. That's why they cut their tails off to about that big, because the last part of the tail breaks. And so they cut that off. Anyway, though, he loves shoes. He loves people. He won't be hunting for vermin. And he won't be getting his tail cut off. He is a perfect dog for me. And I cannot begin to even say how thankful I am that he is in my life. And that as a therapy dog, he will no doubt be good at his job. But just now for me, he helps me with most everything. And that's really important. So to sum it up, what they are able to do is that I find most important is whenever your self-esteem is damaged, or if it's been, let's just say, through a rough spot, unconditional love is something that helps your anxiety, helps all those things. But I'm finding that the biggest thing is self-esteem. And I didn't expect that. I did not expect that. I knew all the other things, but I really didn't expect such a big... it's not that you feel it at first. You just notice suddenly that it's better. So,
And what a wonderful thing.
It is. And he he is sleeping here now. We will not disturb him. But I'm hoping that our editor will put a picture of him in there. And, and by the way, I had my husband take three pictures of him while I was holding him. Because the funniest thing about, or the cutest thing about him, is his face. He has this...
He is an adorable little guy. I mean, he really
is. He is. I mean, he's just precious. And he has this big black nose. And I...
To smell out those badgers.
Oh, that's right. That's right. Anything else he can find right now. He will be neutered in a year. Until then, we're going to have to keep an eye on him. But anyway, so he... got pictures taken, and I sent them to some of my relatives, one in particular, just really his head. Well, it came out looking almost distorted, and so his head looked huge. So one of the people that I sent it to, you know, I had said he, you know, his head looks a little bit, you know, distorted as far as, you know, size. I said, but he does kind of have a big head, if you look at him.
Yeah, he does.
Now, we don't mean...
The rest of his body is still catching
up. That's right, that's right. We don't mean a big head as in being the snob. none of that. He's a good boy. However, he does have a really sweet face, but one of them sent me a note back and said... his face really is big, and they put big in all caps. And then said, is there something wrong with him? I said, no, he is perfect. He just mm-hmm. has to catch up to his head.
Right.
That's all.
Mm-hmm.
And he still, though, is so young that he's entertaining because his front legs know where they're going. The back legs are longer than his front, so they kind of do a little thing on their own. They just kind of go back and forth.
Mm-hmm.
So that's still going on, and I will appreciate and enjoy every moment of it before it ends because it is so darling.
Mm-hmm. Now, did you say what you named him?
Murphy.
Okay. Well,
yes,
I couldn't remember.
His name is Murphy. I was trying
if you shared that.
I don't think I really shared how it went, but we had asked for suggestions. And mm-hmm. someone suggested in an email to the website, Murphy. I had a lot of suggestions, Riley.
Mm-hmm.
And, of course, Finn, the common name they told me not to call him.
Uh-huh.
But anyway, after we got to know him, we realized that he is a Murphy.
Mm-hmm. It does suit him well,
it
I will have to say.
Yes, and so I did settle with that name, and his actual official name on his papers is Griffin. So mm-hmm. actually, he is Murphy Griffin,
mm-hmm.
and that's his middle name. But anyway, so I will let the editor-in-chief post a picture of
yes.
Murphy.
We will definitely show off Murphy. We will share Murphy with the world.
Yes, Murphy will be with me most all the time. Not all the time, but most of the time, whenever I can take him with me. So, anyway, if you have any questions, did I say what he was?
Mm-hmm.
I said Glenna by now. Mm-hmm. You can look it up if you're interested. It's he is a Glen of Imal Terrier, and Imal is spelled I-M-A-A-L. Mm-hmm. And anyway... I hope you do look him up on the internet because they are darling and you'll see some really cute pictures.
Mm-hmm.
So thank you. I wanted to share that with you. And all along, I'm going to be sharing the things that go on when you have a puppy. We've had them all. He's worth it.
Well, good. And I'm looking forward to hearing other Murphy stories,
oh,
the ones that are to come. So,
yes.
But thank you for joining us. And please remember to like and share and subscribe. And we'll see you guys next time.
Thank you.